Four family members will get to sleep in their own beds tonight after spending days stuck at sea on the Carnival Triumph. 4029's Jay Flyburn was at XNA as they stepped off the plane. He tells us this group is focusing on the positive. It's new tonight.
Less than 24 hours after the Triumph docked in Mobile, Alabama, some folks from our area are finally home. And after days with no working bathrooms and very little food, they couldn't hide how happy they are to be back. It was a loud and emotional homecoming on Friday evening as four family members arrived at XNA less than 24 hours after their ill-fated voyage on the Carnival Triumph came to an end.
I just want to put it all behind us. I'm so glad to see my family. That was the hardest part. But other than that, you know, it's just a new day and I'm thankful to be home.
And their family is thankful to have them back.
It feels complete. We're a very big family, and when you don't have them, there's a hole. So it's good. We're excited.
Brad Crabtree, who we met on Thursday, was finally reunited with his wife, Kim, and many young children were also there to greet their parents. The passengers of the Triumph chose not to comment on the conditions they had to deal with, but they did tell us this.
The crew of the ship was phenomenal. They'd done a super job taking care of us.
We made the best of it and had a good time, and we had a large group, and we rallied together and had toga parties and had a good time.
Before the homecoming celebration wrapped up, they even made time to show their Razorback pride, something we're told they also did on the cruise ship.
Razorbacks!
Even in a crisis, we know how to call the hogs.
Now, at one point we heard there was a death on the cruise ship, but according to Leitner, that was just one of many rumors that circulated as the Carnival Triumph was being towed to shore. Angela?
They also told us they were thrilled to get a hotel room last night. They say they finally had a good night's sleep and the food was delicious.